While Lake Champlain appears postcard perfect, trouble's brewing down below.
Right behind you, we had a blue-green toxic algae bloom that ended up blowing around into the next bay over.
Essex, New York lacks a wastewater treatment plant, which means nutrients from people's septic tanks flow into the lake, which can fuel toxic blue-green algae. And if algae gets into the drinking water supply, it's dangerous.
Chlorine doesn't touch it. If you boil it in your house, that doesn't touch it. So if it's there, it's going to be there until it just breaks down over time.
Town Supervisor Ron Jackson has lobbied state and federal lawmakers for the $7 million needed to build a wastewater treatment plant. So far, no luck.
One boat, one part of a plant that was missed because nobody checked could set the whole thing off.
Dozens of invasive species threaten the lake, among them lamprey, zebra mussels, and alewives. Unwelcome visitors who experts say probably came here attached to someone's boat or bait bucket.
It's a matter of people paying attention, being aware of the problem.
Awareness is only part of the solution. Efforts to protect the lake also have to overcome the bureaucracy of two states and two countries. Currently, the governments of New York, Vermont, and Quebec are working together to come up with a rapid response plan, a fast-moving effort to contain an invasive species when it's detected.
Public awareness of the need to protect Lake Champlain has never been greater. Researchers say it's on people's minds more than ever before. But they also say awareness does not always turn into action.
There is still quite a disconnect.
Dr. Mary Watson's research at the University of Vermont centers around the lake and the ways humans impact it.
In Lake Champlain, I think some of the change is very reversible if we stop it now.
Watson advocates a plan which targets the sources of blue-green algae and other pollutants.
And to me, that doesn't mean that we have to spend huge orders of magnitude of money more. We just have to be smarter about how we target our money.
Watson also says we need to be smarter in our everyday lives. For example, organic farming is helping to cut down on phosphate runoff. However, people still need to be careful when doing the little things. Washing cars, taking care of the lawn.
Regular treatment does nothing for blue-green algae.
Back in Essex, while the threat of blue-green algae remains, Ron Jackson is hopeful that funding for a wastewater treatment plant will eventually come through. And he echoes a refrain which sums up the state of the lake.
So there's been certainly improvements, but there's certainly a lot of room for more improvements.